In today's tutorial, we're going to be showing you how to set up your Zoho Bookings account to make sure that you are set up and ready to go. So let's log in and I'll see you there. All right, so now that we're logged in, let's head over to our settings so we can show you what you can do to set it up properly. So over here on the top right is that cog icon. And then over here, it's taking you to a new setup page. So it says up here, basic setup. It is nothing but basic. It is quite in depth. There are a lot of options. And we're going to go through each one of these in a different tutorial. I'm going to go through a lot of detail there. However, what I want to show you in this tutorial was setting up your basic information on the general tab over here on the left-hand side. So on the general tab, we have a lot of options for what we can change. For example, we can change our business name just to clientric.co or whatever it might be, and I'll save that. In this case, we want to have a business email, which will be assigned as the default email for any emails that do go out, whether to your individual users or to potentially your internal users as well. Now, we do have the ability to set up a business email here, and this is a default email address that will be set up to send out notifications to your users, to your clients, whoever they may be, externally as well as internally for your team for any notifications that do get sent out. All right, so adding our email here, we're going to type in casey@clientric.co, and we're going to see that we need to input a 6-digit verification email for this demo. So I'm just going to pull up that email as soon as it comes in, and I'm going to pull in the 6 digits. So give it a minute here. There it is. So I see a number like this. I'm just going to copy and paste it. We're going to verify. And then everything is going to be all good. So the email has been added successfully. So that allows me to have this email as the default email address that goes out to any notifications that get sent. So we can also set up our contact number. I don't want to put that in for this account, but we do have the ability to do it. We can change the time zone that we're in. We can change the currency that we want to charge if we want to charge for a booking. So one of the cool things you can do with Zoho Bookings is you can actually charge per booking. So anytime someone has a consultation with you, maybe you have a free version, maybe you have a longer paid version. And that paid version is something that your individual users, your clients, your prospects can actually pay upfront prior to the meeting actually taking place. So therefore, you know you're going to get paid for your time, which is quite nice. We can change the time format, and we have the ability to remove the Zoho Bookings branding. So if you remember in that last tutorial, I said most of my clients want to remove the Powered by Zoho Bookings down here on the booking link. This would do that. So we can disable it there, and it's done. It's gone. So we can also set the working hours for our company. Right now, they're set from 9 to 6 p.m. If you remember, I set my personal individual working hours from 10 till 2. So we can change this as well, depending on what we might want. We can just click this edit button over here and you can go through and edit those. We also have the ability to add in special working hours. So working on weekends or compensating for time off, then add them here so your customers know when they're available. So you can add in individual users and you could set in dates and times for having that slot available. Now we also have time off, so you can block days off of your schedule. So take a break, make more time for schedules you may have, and you can add in those dates. So let's say you're going to be off for all of maybe Christmas holidays or festival season, whatever that might be, wherever you're located, you can choose specific periods, one-off periods, where you can then manage that effectively for your organization, because you know no one will be available. So let's go ahead and cancel that. Now let's check out the booking page URL. So you can see here, our default booking domain is this. Right now it's user1-demo268.zohobookings.com. That's not super great. So we can go ahead and actually customize this. We can change this on our default booking domain, and we can actually create our own custom domain. So I think that's a very important part, is that we can change this to, let's say, Clientric, we're gonna save, or whatever it might be. Let's say a lot of our clients, we use bookings.clientric.co, for example. So that's our domain. We end up creating a subdomain, which has helped in the past to make it a little bit more branded towards what you're actually doing. So we do have the ability to add in a custom domain here as well. So let's say bookings.clientric.co is what we want to set it as, so we can launch that. Now it's going to give us some information of DNS settings that we need to add to our domain provider. So it's going to tell us that we need to add in the bookings.cs.zohohost.com as the CNAME or any other records here. So right now we're on the CNAME records. We can also add in text records, and we can also add in a file. So for example, we need to add in this name, the MNRJ65E, and then the value it points to is that link. So that's one thing we need to do, and then we can then verify it. Now, as soon as we've given enough time to take hold, we can click verify now. And what would happen is you'd get a green symbol here, or you'd get a red notification here that says, I'm sorry, we could not verify your domain. So that's how you go about setting that up. If you're not familiar with how to set up your domain settings, either drop us a comment and we'll post a link on how you can go about doing that, or you can also do some research yourself, and there's lots of links out there. So just let us know if you need some help. We're more than happy to lend a hand if you do need it. Now, we also have in-product notifications. So this is specifically for various different products. So we can set a rescheduled, we can set a canceled or a scheduled, and a consultant notify when. And now we also have the in-product notifications. So this would be like a little notification tab up here if you are spending time in it. Most of our clients don't spend a ton of time in this application, so I don't really think this is necessary, but you can go ahead and create some in-product notifications or in Zoho Bookings notifications for whenever any of these things happen. So you can notify your individual user in the application itself when a customer has been created, when a customer has been edited, when a customer has been deleted, and so on and so on. So keep that in the back of your mind if you do think that would be useful for your business purposes. The last thing I want to show you are custom labels. We do have the ability to change this. So for example, we can rename any of the items that are in our system. As I originally set up this company as a business consulting company, it then set up all this based off of those items. So for example, it's a consultation, and it has many consultations. So that's the plural and the singular. We also have the staff, so consultant and consultants. So for example, you might have a medical practice that you're running. You could have doctors and assistants or something along those lines. You could change this depending on what your industry is. And then we also have the ability to change the resource labels. So right now it's just resource and resources, but let's say you want to change it to meeting rooms. So we could say meeting room over here, or many would be meeting rooms. So that's how you'd go about setting that up. Now, that's it for this video. It's a very quick overview of the general basic setup. We're gonna be diving into each one of these items on the left here in a lot more detail, so be prepared for that. And as always, make sure you subscribe to our channel below. We want to make sure that everyone who needs help is getting help. So you subscribing, you liking and commenting our videos will definitely help us reach more individuals that are needing this help. As always, feel free to join our other social channels like Facebook and Instagram. We're building an awesome community and we can't wait to have you there. Bye for now.